Welcome to our online class. This is Mom Teresa Tubal. Join me to enjoy mathematics. Are you ready to explore in dividing polynomials using synthetic division? In dividing polynomials, we may use long division or synthetic division. And what is synthetic division? It is a process that makes use of numerical coefficients in dividing polynomials in which the divisor is a binomial in the form x minus c. What are the procedures in dividing polynomials using synthetic division? So the first step, we need to arrange the coefficients, arranging from highest exponent to lowest exponent. After arranging, we need to bring down all the leading coefficient. After bring down the third step, we need to multiply. After multiplying, the fourth step, we need to add or subtract. And then the last step, we need to repeat the step 2 and then 3. So let us apply. You can write the result of the division as follows: q of x plus r of x over d of x. So yung given, pwedeng nakasulat na p of x divided by the d of x or p of x over d of x, where p of x is the dividend, d of x is divisor, q of x quotient, and r of x is the remainder. So let us divide x squared plus 8x plus 15 divided by x plus 5. So we need to get the value of x. So x plus 5 is equal to 0, so x is equal to negative 5. So positive 5, change the sign, negative 5. X is bring down. Next, x squared plus 8x plus 15. We need to get the leading coefficient. So this one, naka-arrange na siya from highest exponent to lowest exponent. And then, we need to get the leading coefficient. So the leading coefficient is 1. This one, 8x is 8. And this one is equal to 15. So we need to divide. So bring down 1. After bring down 1, we need to multiply. So 1 times negative 5 is negative 5. So ilalagay natin siya sa tapat ng 8. Next, 8 minus 5, the answer is equal to 3. And then afterwards, we need to multiply it again. 3 times negative 5 is negative 15. So 15 minus 15, the answer is equal to 0. So the answer, so x squared, this one, x squared divided by x. So, lalagyan natin yung 1 ng x. So, x plus 3. So, it means the quotient is equal to x plus 3. So, let us check. Let us multiply x plus 3 times x plus 5. Let us see if the answer is x squared plus 8x plus 15. So, x times x is x squared. X times 3 is 3x. And then after multiplying x plus 3 times x, let us multiply 5 times x, that is 5x. 5 times 3, that is equal to 15. Afterwards, we need to add. So bring down x squared. 3 plus 5 is 8x, and then positive 15. So it means the answer is equal to x squared plus 8x plus 15. It means the quotient is equal to x plus 3. X squared plus 11x minus 12 divided by x plus 12. We need to identify the value of x. So x plus 12 equals 0. So x is equal to negative 12. So positive 12 going to the right side, that becomes negative 12. Next, so x squared plus 11x minus 12 arranged from highest exponent to the lowest exponent. So nakaayos na to. Let us get the leading coefficient. So the leading coefficient of x squared, yung katabi ni x squared is 1. The leading coefficient of x is 11. And then the constant is negative 12. Bring down 1. After bring down 1, 1 times negative 12 is negative 12. 11 minus 12, subtract 1, copy the big sign, that is negative 1. Negative 1 times negative 12, the answer is equal to positive 12. So, negative 12 plus 12, the answer is equal to 0. So, the quotient, so again, x squared divided by x is x. So, 1x minus 1. So, the final answer for the quotient is x minus 1. How about number 3? X cubed minus 10x minus 13 divided by x plus 2. So we need to get the value of the divisor. X plus 2 is equal to 0. Solve for x. So x is equal to negative 2. Positive 2, change the sign, that is negative 2. So kung negative naman to, change the sign, this become positive 2. Next, let us get the dividend. So it must be arranged from highest exponent to the lowest exponent. So x cubed. So, walang x squared, so let us write 0x squared minus 10x minus 13. Afterwards, let us get the leading coefficient. So, the leading coefficient, katabi ni x cubed is 1, and then 0, katabi ni x is negative 10, and then negative 13. So, let us divide. Bring down 1, and then 1 times negative 2 is negative 2. 0 minus 2, subtract, copy the big sign, the answer is negative 2. Negative 2 times negative 2, multiply, 2 times 2 is 4. And then negative times negative, the answer is equal to positive 4. Again, subtract, copy the big sign. So 6, copy the big sign, that is negative 6. Negative 6 times negative 2 is positive 12. Negative times negative is positive. 6 times 2, the answer is equal to 12. Negative 13 plus 12, so it means the remainder is equal to negative 1. What is now the quotient now? Because the remainder is equal to negative 1. So the answer, again, x cubed divided by x, that is x squared. So this become 1x squared, and then minus, so pababa, minus 2. Let us write x, and then minus 6 as the constant. And then our remainder is negative 1 all over by the divisor, that is x plus 2. So it means the final answer is x squared minus 2x minus 6 minus 1 all over x plus 2. How about number 4? X cubed plus 100 minus 13x squared divided by x minus 3. So let us get the value of the divisor. X minus 3 is equal to 0. Let us solve for x. So x is equal to positive 3. Change the sign of negative 3, that becomes positive 3. Let us get the dividend. So if we get the dividend, let us arrange from highest exponent to lowest exponent. So x cubed, copy x cubed, negative 13x squared, and then x, walang x, so let us write 0x plus 100. Afterwards, let us get all the leading coefficients. So yung katabi ni x cubed is 1. Katabi ni x squared is negative 13. Katabi ni x, 0, and then the constant is equal to 100. So let us divide. Bring down 1. After bring down 1, let us multiply. 1 times 3, the answer is equal to 3. Subtract, copy the big sign. So, 13 minus 3 is 10. Copy the big sign, that is negative 10. Negative 10 times 3 is negative 30. 0 minus 30, the answer is equal to negative 30. Negative 30 times 3, so multiply 30 times 3, that is equal to 90. Negative times positive is negative 90. 100 minus 90, the answer is equal to positive 10. So, to get the quotient, so again, x cubed divided by x, that is x squared. So, let us write 1 and then x squared. So, pwedeng isulat yung 1, pwedeng wag na lang. Minus, so pababa, minus 10x minus 30 and then plus the remainder, that is equal to 10. All over by the divisor x minus 3. So it means the quotient is x squared minus 10x minus 30 plus 10 all over x minus 3. So let us apply what you have learned in dividing polynomials using synthetic division. Instruction, pause the video and try to solve on your own. Divide x squared minus x minus 12 by x minus 4. What is the answer? Correct. The answer is equal to x plus 3. Question number 2. Let us divide x cubed minus 4x squared plus x plus 6 divided by x minus 1. What is the answer? Correct. The answer is equal to x squared minus 3x minus 2 plus 4 over x minus 1. What are the steps in dividing polynomials using synthetic division? The procedures, first, we need to arrange the coefficient from highest exponent to lowest exponent. Second, we need to bring down the leading coefficient. After bring down the leading coefficient, third, we need to multiply. After multiplying, fourth step, we need to add or subtract. After adding or subtract, repeat the step 3 and 4. You can write the result of the division as follows. Q of x plus R of x over D of x. So, yung given, pwedeng nakasulat na P of x divided by the D of x or P of x over D of x, where P of x is the dividend, D of x is divisor, Q of x quotient, and R of x is the remainder. I hope you learned in dividing polynomials using synthetic division. Enjoy learning mathematics! I'm Teresa Tubal. Thank you so much!